Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren.
And I'm Larry.
And in this video, we're going to talk about solar trackers compared to fixed mount solar systems. So Larry, let's talk about solar trackers. What are they and how do they work?
So there's two basic types of solar trackers. One is the single axis tracker, which basically tilts the modules from the east in the morning to the west in the afternoon as the sun goes down. The second option is a dual tilt tracker, which can track east and west and north and south. So a steeper tilt in the wintertime when the sun's lower, a shallower tilt in the summertime when the sun's higher. And the basic main reason why people install solar trackers is because since it's following the sun all day long, or in the case of a dual axis, all year long, it generates more production.
And so with this more production and the ability to track east and west and north and south, I assume there's more cost.
There is more cost. There's typically about 40% more cost and about 40% more production, approximately. Sometimes it's pretty close to even.
And then what about maintenance?
Maintenance is another big challenge with solar trackers. Now suddenly you've introduced moving parts.
Yeah.
With a fixed tilt system, the solar panels are just sitting there all day long. The racking just needs to hold the solar panels up and you're good. With trackers, now you've got motors, you've got moving parts, and so most trackers are going to require at least a yearly maintenance schedule, and then some have additional maintenance every 5 years as well.
Let's talk about the fixed-mounted systems that don't have moving parts. What are typical applications for those?
Yeah, so that's nearly all of the systems we do are going to be fixed-mount. That can be flush-mounted on a roof,
yep.
So the same pitch as a roof. It can be tilted up on a roof, like if you have a flat commercial roof, we might tilt the panels up to get some more production. It can be a ground mount, a fixed tilt ground mount, or it can be a carport as well. Those are all examples of a fixed tilt system.
And then let's jump into some of the pros and cons of the fixed systems.
So the pros and cons, I mean, the big pro for the fixed tilt system is there's no moving parts.
Yeah.
So you don't need to worry about maintenance on the racking side of things. However, it's going to be lower production. And it's going to be dependent on the orientation and tilt of the roof or the mounting structure it's on. So with the ground mount, you have a little bit more option. Let's face it, due south. Let's tilt it up a little more to get a little more production. For a roof mount, if you're flush mounted, you're subject to the orientation and the tilt of that roof.
Yeah. Another pro is that it's less expensive than a tracker.
Right. Less expensive to build, significantly less expensive. But then lower production then as well.
Yeah, and no maintenance, less cost.
No maintenance concerns. Now, one thing I will say with a carport is going to be significantly more expensive than the ground mount. It's higher up in the air, a lot higher wind load and snow load considerations, and just more challenging to build overall.
So what do we typically sell or install here?
In nearly every case, we're going to sell and install, we're going to recommend the fixed tilt system.
Yeah.
We'll gladly install the dual axis tracker. That's not a problem. We can do that. We've done that. But for most customers, in most cases, it's going to be the fixed tilt system that's going to make the most sense.
So in summary, the solar trackers have moving parts. So those moving parts allow you to get the additional production because they can move from east to west during the day, north to south during the seasons changes. But they do come with additional maintenance costs, and they're more expensive out the gate. Whereas the fixed mounted systems that we install do not have moving parts. So less maintenance and less cost involved in those, but you would need more space to get the same amount of production that you would in a fixed or a tracker system. If you'd like to learn more, we have a video linked in the description below on the differences between ground mounts and roof mounts. Also, we have a very cool video that'll be linked below on a solar sunflower. We hope you found this valuable, and thanks for watching.